Had some conversations this morning. I've been seeing some Facebook posts, questions about treating some issues in the neck and the shoulders. Thought I would come on today and teach you one of the techniques that I like to teach my patients when they have a lot of neck issues. The neck issues could be coming from overstretch in the back, tightness in the front. Maybe they've got some swelling and blockage restrictions that are affecting just the tissue mobility as well as the ability to drain. I wanted to show you a stretch that I like to do that actually helps accomplish both of those things. A lot of times when people have neck pain, they tend to want to keep working on the back of their neck and the back of their shoulders or working down the back of their body. Sometimes they need that too, but most often you need to work away from where the problem is because that's typically where the solution is going to come from. This is actually a stretch that you can do that affects the front of your neck and the sides of your neck as well. What you're going to want to do is skin to skin. I just want you to put your hand on your sternum, put the other hand on top, and then just take a deep breath. As you exhale, just let the weight of your arms create a little bit of a drag on your sternums. You're actually dragging your arms this direction, down towards your feet. I'm not sliding, I'm just dragging. It's just creating some tension there. And then what I tell people to do is you can tip your head back a little bit just till you feel a stretch. You feel that through here. Or you can go to the side and you might feel more of a stretch here along the side. And you want to keep that tension. I've let my hands shift a little bit this way. I've kind of got a diagonal stretch going on here to actually stretch out this whole side here. This is really good for your TMJ joint. It's good for drainage through your neck. It's good for loosening up some of the tension that's pulling up through in the neck here that's causing the back of your neck to actually work harder. You want to stay here a minimum of 3 to 5 minutes. Once you've been in that position, you might want to go to the center or you might want to go to the other side. But each time you do it, you got to start that clock over. You got to stay there at least 3 minutes. It takes a minimum of 90 seconds to 120 seconds just to start a release. That's a minute and a half to 2 minutes just to start it. To get things to open up, you want to stay there longer. If you can stay there for 10 minutes, even better. The longer you stay there, the more things are going to open.